If there's two things that everyone loves, it's anime and the MCU. Too bad there isn't any way to combine those two. Or is there? Have you ever taken a look at your favorite anime characters and wondered which Marvel Cinematic Universe character they're most like? Well, we have, and we've compiled a nice long list of 20 anime characters and their MCU counterparts. This is the crossover you've all been waiting for. It's finally time for the heroes from the East and West to meet. Let's get started. Ally to good, nightmare to you. Goku made this speech, but it wouldn't be out of place coming out of Steve Rogers' mouth. Goku's MCU counterpart is none other than Captain America. These two are both the ultimate symbol of what a hero is. A force of justice, protector of the weak, and a really hard fist in the jaw of evil. Goku and Captain America are the characters who all others in their respective series look up to. Even when facing foes even more powerful than them, they always find a way. They're both also the leaders of a group of the greatest fighters of all time. For Goku, it's the Z Fighters, and of course, Captain America is the face and the heart and everything else of the Avengers. Bronze versus brains? Why choose only one? Gohan is the embodiment of this. He's a renowned scholar who's been one of the most powerful members of the Z Fighters since his introduction to the series. But just like his MCU counterpart, his enormous reservoirs of strength can only be tapped into when he's enraged. Even as a 5-year-old who'd never even trained to fight a day in his life, he managed to land a devastating blow on Raditz, who, at the time, was the most powerful foe the heroes of Earth had ever faced. The same pattern repeated on Namek and in the Cell Saga. Gohan's MCU counterpart is none other than the Hulk himself, Bruce Banner. Bruce Banner is just your everyday nuclear scientist, definitely one you'd call to help you with your science homework rather than tag in for a fight. That is, until you get him angry. Once Bruce gets mad, he transforms into the Incredible Hulk, one of the most powerful beings in the MCU. Give it up for Nerd Rage, everyone. Screw the rules, I have money applies to both characters in this next pair. Sato Kaiba from Yu-Gi-Oh! And Tony Stark from the Iron Man films are made for each other. Both of these heroes are the genius CEOs of their own billion-dollar tech mega corporations. Both Kaiba Corporation and Stark Industries made their fortunes under their original owners as arms dealers. But their new owners had different plans for them. Kaiba switched Kaiba Corp's focus to entertainment and gaming, creating two amusement parks, dual arenas, and several generations of dual discs. After shutting down Stark Industries' weapons division, Tony shifted the mission toward tech that would make the world a safer place. But that's not all. These two are two of the most arrogant and self-centered characters you'll ever see. Tony Stark never misses an opportunity to refer to himself as a genius billionaire playboy philanthropist. And Kaiba? Well, not only does he see himself as the greatest duelist in the world, but the man also insists on flying himself around in a plane designed to look like his favorite trading card game monster. Trying to save the universe by murdering a large portion of its inhabitants is quite the big brain strategy. And it's a strategy shared by both Thanos and the Anti-Spiral from Tangentopa Gurren Lagann. Both villains operate on the premise that a glut of life forms in the universe would bring ultimate annihilation. Thanos believed that overpopulation would cause great suffering as resources become too scarce. The Anti-Spiral believed that an unchecked population of life forms, such as humans who were able to harness spiral energy, would lead to a collapse of the universe. So they both fought to suppress other life forms in order to prevent their own respective apocalyptic scenarios. Thanos used the power of the Infinity Gauntlet to snap half the universe's population out of existence. The Anti-Spiral made a deal with Lord Genome to keep the human population on Earth below 1 million. When the number of human beings exceeded this, the Anti-Spiral went on the offensive to annihilate the entire human race. Eric Killmonger and Sasuke Uchiha. Both warriors from prestigious bloodlines, hailing from hidden nations. Sasuke is the last son of the Uchiha clan from the Hidden Leaf Village. Killmonger is deposed royalty from the hidden hyper-advanced African nation of Wakanda. The driving force for both of these men's entire lives have been the extermination of their families ordered by the place they called home. The entire Uchiha clan was ordered to be wiped out by Itachi, Sasuke's older brother. Sasuke was the only one spared. Not knowing that Itachi did all of this in order to protect him, Sasuke made it his life's mission to kill his brother, even betraying the Leaf Village to do it. Eric Killmonger's father was murdered by his brother T'Chaka, King of Wakanda and the Black Panther. This inspired Eric to train his entire life so that one day he could rise up against the Wakanda royal family and take the throne for himself. Eventually, Sasuke returned to the Leaf Village and joined their side once again. Killmonger died in battle without switching to Black Panther's side. One returned to being a hero, while the other died a villain. Who doesn't love a character who's hot-tempered, smart-mouthed, and who really, really loves shooting guns? Revy from Black Lagoon is the number one enforcer of the Lagoon Company. She fires off as many insults to her enemies and crewmates as she does bullets. Her weapons of choice are a pair of modified Beretta 92F pistols that she dual-wields, earning her the nickname Two Hands. Her anime counterpart is Rocket Raccoon. He's a similarly mouthy gun wielder who can't get his day started without a good round of ultra-violence. Both of these characters are the resident spitfires of a band of misfits and outlaws. These are characters you'll love to cheer for, but still pray you don't catch them in a bad mood, unless you like dodging bullets. If you're like Spike Spiegel and love a woman who can kick your butt, then this pair is for you. The anime character? Sakuyo from Gintama. The Marvel Cinematic Universe character? Natasha Romanoff, Black Widow. In the underground red light district of Yoshiwara, Sakuyo keeps the hotbed of scum and villainy from getting out of control. If you cross her, prepare to be skewered by a storm of kunai. Black Widow is just as deadly. Under the Russian KGB, she was one of the top assassins in the world. And after defecting, she became one of the greatest agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Despite being a non-superpowered human, she was so skilled that she was able to go toe-to-toe with world and even universe-ending threats. Izuku Midoriya, also known by his hero name Deku, started his hero life as green as he could be. He didn't even have any powers when he ran thoughtlessly into danger to save his childhood friend, Bakugo. It was this act of bravery that inspired his own idol, All Might, to take him under his wing. Deku's MCU counterpart is none other than the Spider-Man himself, Peter Parker. Peter's the same age as Deku and just as new to the hero game. Both of them were born without powers and both of them received them at about the same age. Peter was doing his own heroics for a while before Tony Stark noticed him. Peter had already idolized Tony and was ecstatic to have him for a mentor. Both of these young heroes have a lot to learn. Some might say they're too sensitive for the world of superheroing, but gradually they're proving they have what it takes. They're not only growing as heroes, but also just as mature young men. They're learning to step out of the shadows of the mentors and figure out who they really are as people. A trickster from space who only drops into the main characters' lives to manipulate and cause trouble? Well, we've got a pair for you. For the anime side, meet Haruko Haruhara from Fooly Cooly. Her MCU counterpart is the trickster god himself, Loki. Everything is a game for these two. When Haruko isn't trying to tease an intergalactic portal out of the forehead of some poor puberty-stricken teen, she's battling space law enforcement who are trying to keep her away from her number one goal, ultimate power. Sound familiar? Do androids dream of electric sheep? We can't say, but what we do know is that these two hero androids definitely have heart. Android 16 and Vision were both originally created to serve the purposes of a powerful villain. Android 16 was made with one purpose, to kill Goku. Vision was initially meant to serve as a perfect body for the rogue AI Ultron to inhabit, but both made their way to the good guy's side. Android 16, who was once only motivated by his programming to kill Goku, began to appreciate life. He put himself in harm's way to protect his siblings, 17 and 18. And his death at the hands of Cell inspired Gohan to reach Super Saiyan 2 and save the world. There's nothing more fun than a goofy space captain leading a crew of misfits. Meet Space Dandy. He's a dandy guy in space. For fun and profit, he scours the galaxy for rare aliens with his sometimes brave crewmates Cutie the Robot and the cat-like alien Meow. His MCU counterpart is Peter Quill, also known as Star-Lord. Star-Lord created his own family of outcasts in the crew members of the Guardians of the Galaxy. Both of these men may come off as a couple of idiots sometimes, okay, most of the time, but they have huge wells of hidden potential that even they themselves were oblivious to. Star-Lord is half-human, half-celestial. This makes him stronger and more durable than a normal human. He even formerly had the power to manipulate energy and matter. Space Dandy is actually a godlike cosmic being who can traverse between alternate dimensions. He even got a chance to be God of the Universe, but he turned it down so he could keep going to his favorite restaurants, which is a place I think Star-Lord would appreciate. The main hero of the story can't hog all the attention. Sometimes you need a person who can see the bigger picture and put themselves through the ringer to make their vision come into play so the main heroes can do their job. On the anime side, we have Erwin Smith from Attack on Titan. He's the mastermind behind rescuing Eren from the Marley Titan Shifters. He was also in charge of the operation to retake Walmaria, bravely sacrificing his life to make the plan a success. His MCU counterpart is Nick Fury. Nick plays a similar role to Erwin. As the leader of S.H.I.E.L.D., he is the big picture man. He's the connective tissue of the Avengers, responsible for bringing them all together in the first place and also helping them stay together. And while he's not a Norse god or a super soldier, he's not afraid to get his hands dirty in a fight when the situation calls for it. Just like Erwin isn't afraid to be the first one to charge into battle despite not being a Titan shifter like Aaron. Magic and suffering, together at last. Hamura spent years reliving the same few weeks over and over again, desperately trying to save her friends from certain doom. Eventually, she falls in despair and becomes what she sought to destroy, a witch. To cope with her failure to protect her best friend, Madoka, Hamura creates her own world under her control. If this sounds familiar to you, then you already know who her MCU counterpart is, Wanda Maximoff, the Scarlet Witch. Wanda's had a hard life too. She's lost her parents, her twin brother, and the love of her life, Android 16, Vision. In WandaVision, we see her cope with all of this loss and tragedy by creating a fake world. An idyllic world where she could live a sitcom-perfect life with the now-deceased Vision and Pietro along with the children she never had. Both of these heroes are extremely powerful characters who were driven to despair by their inability to save their loved ones. These two are probably the only ones in the world who could truly understand each other. Strength is useful, but sometimes what you really need to secure the win is some good old-fashioned science. After a mysterious light turned all humans on Earth into stone, Senku awakens and decides to revive the rest of the world through science. He finds himself in a world that has reverted to the Stone Age, and using his vast scientific knowledge, leapfrogs scientific progress by hundreds and even thousands of years at a time. His MCU counterpart is Shuri, head scientist of Wakanda and sister to Black Panther T'Challa. Most notably, she created upgraded versions of T'Challa's Black Panther suit. These two go together because of their skill and dedication in the field of science. Whether it's speedrunning the invention of cell phones or making an invincible superhero costume, these are both the kids you wish you could have had for a partner in your high school science class. Takamura is the ultimate boxer. He's never lost a single match and is well on his way into his mission of becoming the world champion in every weight class from junior middleweight all the way to heavyweight. Some would say he's a boxing god. Speaking of gods, Takamura's MCU counterpart would be the God of Thunder himself, Thor. They're brash, boastful, and incredibly powerful. They've also had their fair share of setbacks that they've learned and grown from. Thor has had to deal with exile, losing his ability to wield his hammer and the loss of his own family members. Takamura has also faced exile in a way, as he left his family after embarrassing his older brother by starting a fight with hecklers at his older brother's rugby game. And while he's never lost a match, he's had to go through serious trials in exhaustion and dehydration as he attempted to make weight for his matches. When we're talking about blonde superpowered heroes with dark pasts, it's gotta be Android 18 from Dragon Ball Z paired up with Captain Marvel. Now she's married to Krillin and helps the Z-Fighters defend the Earth. Captain Marvel has a similar story. Just like 18, she also started out as an ordinary human. But after she gained cosmic powers, her memories were wiped and she was used as a weapon by the Kree in the war between the Kree and the Skrulls. But now she's her own person again and she's using her powers to fight for the side of good. Being blind isn't always a handicap. For some heroes and villains, it can give them the edge to outskill their opponents. Two great examples of this are Sarah from Samurai Champloo and Matthew Murdock, aka Daredevil. Despite being blind, Sarah was able to outfight both Master Swordsmen, Jin and Mugen. Thanks to years of training, Daredevil has similar abilities. His blindness amplified his other senses, allowing him to be the most dangerous man in Hell's Kitchen. Isn't being rich the easiest way to become a villain? Sometimes money can be the greatest superpower. This pair is as sadistic as they are wealthy. Meet Kazutaka Hayato, president of the Taiya Corporation from Kaiji. His MCU brother is Wilson Fisk, aka Kingpin. While Kingpin wanted to become the owner of a New York criminal empire, Hayato set his sights on building an underground kingdom built on slave labor. Different scales, same concept. Kami is an ancient being who's been the hidden guardian of the Earth for hundreds of years. He may not be one to take to the front lines, but he's still very important to keeping the world safe. When Goku needed to get strong enough to defeat King Piccolo, Kami served as a valuable mentor. It was thanks to Kami's guidance that Goku finally became strong enough to defeat both the Demon King Piccolo and his offspring Piccolo Jr. Kami's MCU counterpart is the Ancient One. Similar to Kami, the Ancient One defended the Earth from terrible threats, all while living hidden away. It was thanks to her leadership that Dr. Stephen Strange was able to become Sorcerer Supreme and defend the world from mystical threats. There's firepower, and then there's firepower. When you need all the guns you want plus 100 more, then you call Metal Knight. The S-ranked hero in the One Punch Man universe is a force to be reckoned with, even though he's never seen the front lines. His powerful drones are powerful enough to vaporize city blocks. His MCU counterpart is War Machine. War Machine is what you get when you take Iron Man's suit and walk it through a Raytheon factory and grab everything you see. Look, I know what you're gonna say. You're gonna tell us we forgot Black Panther. But we didn't. He's not on this list because there's no one like Black Panther. He's one of a kind. Thanks for watching.